gloria a Dios, Dios les bendiga en esta preciosa hora, mi amigo. God bless you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. We're here to preach to you the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ. The Bible says that Jesus Christ died, was buried, and was rose again the third day. Jesucristo.
You gotta do it like this.
Oh, perdón. Jesucristo murió por tus pecados, amigo y amiga. Los tiempos, los juicios de Dios están cerca. Busca a Jesucristo antes de que sea demasiado tarde, mi amigo. Ya no endurezcas tu corazón. Dice la palabra de Dios en 2 Corintios, capítulo 1, verso número 6.
But kind of acts strange because you kind of have to. Oh no, you have to move it down a little bit.
I don't know how to use it.
And it's like this. Look, like this. You hold it like that.
Okay.
No, like you know how you were holding on to the black part like that.
Oh, okay. See?
If you can, yeah.
Yeah, the Bible says in 2 Thessalonians 1:8 that Jesus Christ will return in flaming fire, taking vengeance on those who do not know Jesus Christ and who do not obey the gospel. He shall be punished by everlasting destruction for the presence of the Lord and for the glory of his power. Jesucristo va a venir, pero no va a volver a morir por ti otra vez. Aleluya. Reconcíliate con Jesús antes de que sea demasiado tarde. Los 21 juicios de Jesús, de Dios, vendrán a esta tierra, mi amigo.
Aleluya.
Ya no endurezcas tu corazón. Arrepiéntete antes de que sea demasiado tarde. Cristo te ama. Cristo es amor, es cierto. Pero él es fuego consumidor. Dice Apocalipsis capítulo 9 que si tu nombre, si tú tienes el sello de Dios en tu frente, te van a picar los demonios por 5 meses. You're gonna be stung by my friends. Aleluya. John 3:16 says, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, so whoever believes in him shall not perish but have everlasting life. For God sent us his son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved. He that believeth on him is not condemned, but he who refused to believe is condemned already, because he has not believed in the God. We're infected with a virus called sin. Sin destroys, sin kills, my friends. You gotta turn away from your sin. The Bible says, enter ye by the straight gate, for broad is the way and wide is the gate that leads to destruction. The Bible says there's a place called hell, and in Matthew 13:41-43 says the Lord shall come down from heaven with his mighty angels and take things that offend, all things that offend, and shall cast them in the outer rod, which should be waiting and gnashing of teeth. The truth is, all of us have sinned, but the problem is many of you guys are gonna die. Judgment is coming. The 21 judgments of God, it's coming. The 7 seals are going to open. The blood of the Lord, like I mentioned earlier. And if you're not covered with the blood of the Lamb, you're going to get stung. If you die tonight without Jesus Christ, your final destination will be hellfire.
Preach!
Revelation 20:15 says, if anyone's name is not found written in the book of life, shall be cast into the lake of fire. Si tu nombre no está escrito en el libro de la vida, serás lanzado al lago de fuego y azufre. Es la muerte segunda. Ya no endurezcas tu corazón, querido amigo. Ya no endurezcas tu corazón. Ven a los pies de Jesús. Deja el adulterio. Deja la moralidad. Deja la idolatría. Deja la religión. No te va a salvar, aleluya. La religión no te va a salvar. Tus obras no te van a salvar. Yo voy a salvar. Vive de sed. Que volver a ser mi Jesus Christ. God is angry with the wicked every day. Dios está enojado con el impío todos los días, mi amigo. Ya no endurezcas tu corazón. Mejor arrepiéntate. Ask God for forgiveness when you get home. Cuando llegues a tu casa, clámale a Dios. Dile que ya no quieres ser un pecador, que ya no quieres ser un gran perverso.
Amen.
Puede librar. Yo antes era un gran rebelde. Era un gran malcriado. Aleluya. Hasta que vine a los pies de Jesús. Él me rescató. Me rescató, amigo, así como me rescató a mí hace 3 años. Lo mismo voy a hacer contigo. I've been a Christian for 4 years. The same way he did to me, he did it to you, my friends.
True.
All you have to do is cry out to Jesus Christ. Obey Jesus. Jesus said,
exactly, true.
Keep my commandments. Deja la borrachera. Deja las mujeres. Deja de andar de perverso. Aleluya. Porque si te arrepentís, te atarás fuego al infierno. Así que arrepiéntate. demasiado tarde, mi amigo. Aleluya. Deja a la mujer ajena. Tu mujer que me estás escuchando, deja al marido que no es tuyo. Porque si no te arrepentís, los dos se van a revolcar en el infierno. No querés ir a ese lugar de condenación eterna. Arrepiéntate antes de que sea demasiado tarde. Ya sé que no, yo hago mucha bulla, yo sé. Pero eso es lo que va a tocar, dice Lucas 13:3. Si no te arrepentís, vas a perecer igualmente. Deja de ser perverso, deja de ser rebelde, aleluya. Porque en el infierno el orgullo se va a acabar. Y yo me las cuido, es. ¡Ah! That's how I say, leave the pride, accept Jesus Christ and stop being prideful. The Bible says in Ephesians 2:8, where by grace we're saved, not worthless any man should boast. You need to repent, my friends. I gotta repent once. Everyone in here, and St. Peter and Adams, you guys won't have no excuse until the day of judgment. So my question is for you, where do you go? You want to go to heaven or you want to go to hell? Those are the two choices, my friends. So you have to let anyone go. Leave the fornication. The Bible says in 1 Corinthians 6:9 and 10, do you not know that the unrighteous cannot inherit the kingdom of God? Do not be deceived, neither fornicators, nor idolaters, nor possessors, nor effeminates, nor idolaters, nor abusers of the soul with the mankind, nor thieves, nor covetous, nor drunkards, nor a church to enter that kingdom. If you live in any of those sins, you shall not inherit the kingdom of God. The Bible, the word of God is going to judge you. And if you don't want to go to hell, my friends, a lot of you guys say to go there, but I don't want you to go there. I want you to go to heaven. I want you to find eternal life. Jesus Christ wants to save you, my friends. Stop. Let your pride go. Let your sin go. Wherever it is. He changed me. He could change you. He could change you, my friends, from inside and out. That's why, like right here, we're preaching to you because we want you to be saved. There's people who are dying of car accidents. Every day people die of car accidents, and you could be one of them. You don't know. There's thousands of people who die of car accidents. And you're not even promised tomorrow. You're not even promised the next one. You're not even promised 10 minutes, or you could die anytime. So whatever sin you're doing, give it away. The Bible says in Matthew 16:24, if any man wants to come after me, let him deny himself, take up his cross. For whosoever will save his life shall lose it. But whosoever loses his life for my sake shall find it. For what should a profit a man to gain the whole world and lose his own soul? Or what should a man gain? Jesus Christ say, if you are ashamed of me, of my words, the Son of Man shall be ashamed of you. He will deny Jesus before man. He will deny you before his Father, which is in heaven. Hallelujah. Si tú niegas a Jesucristo, Él te va a negar a ti. No te dice la palabra, que no todo el que me diga Señor, Señor, entrará el reino de los cielos, mas el que hace la voluntad de mi Padre que está en los cielos. Muchos dirán en este día, Señor, Señor, no profetizamos en tu nombre, y en tu nombre hemos echado fuera demonios, y en tu nombre hemos profetizado y haciendo eso y lo otro. Entonces les dirá, no los conozco, apartados de mí, hacedor de maldad, aleluya. Así te va a decir el Señor. You don't know how to hear those words. Jesus Christ is going to say, I never knew you. A lot of people are going to say, Lord, Lord, I never went to church in your name. And in your name, we have prophesied, we have spoken. And he'll say, I never knew you. Depart from me, you workers of iniquity. That's what Jesus Christ is going to say to you, my friend. You don't want to hear those words from Jesus Christ. If anyone needs prayer, si tú necesitas oración, queremos orar por ti, amigo. Ya no seas orgulloso, deja la soberbia, rebelde. Deja esa soberbia ya. Stop being rebellious towards God and Father Jesus Christ. In Proverbs 14 it says, there's a way that seems right to a man, and it leads to death. As I said earlier, Romans 6:23 says, for the wages of sin is death, but it's eternal life through Christ Jesus our Lord. And another passage I want to read to you guys is,
America is trying
to cry out for Jesus. Cry out for Jesus.
Got it.
Yeah. Here, chapter Malachi, quote for me. Behold, the day cometh that shall burn as an oven, and all the proud, yeah, all that do wickedly shall be stubble, and the day that cometh shall burn them up. Saith the Lord of hosts, that shall leave them neither root or branch. This is what's going to happen if you die in your sins, my friends. The Bible says if your name's not found written in the book of life, you'll be cast into the lake which burns with fire and brimstone. If you're righteous, you're only going to die once, my friends. But if you break it, you're going to die twice. Judgment is coming to America for legalizing sin. Los juicios de Dios vendrán a esta nación. Arrepentidos y convertidos, dice el Señor Jesús. En Hechos 3:19, arrepiéntate o pereceréis. Lucas 3:3. Luke 13:3 says, after you repent, you shall all likewise perish. We don't want you to perish, my friends, that's why we're here. You have to strive. You have to live holy. You have to live in holiness, hallelujah. Jesus Christ wants to set you free from all your sins, my friends. You must repent, and you must believe in the death, burial, resurrection. The Bible says in 1 John chapter 1, verse 9, that if you confess your sins, He is faithful and just to forgive you and cleanse you from all unrighteousness. None of us are righteous. None of us. None of us are righteous. And I guess if you need any prayer, you could come to us. And my job as a Christian is to preach to you the grace and the mercy and the judgment of God. God's angry. He loves you so much that He sends His only begotten Son. But it's up to you if you want to receive the free gift of eternal life. It's free today. Don't wait till tomorrow because you know what tomorrow's going to hold. A lot of people are dying. A lot of people are perishing. People are dying left and right, and you could be next. You don't know. You could die, you could choke. You could choke a pizza. You could choke a burrito. Not even the coronavirus, like all the deaths. They're gonna say it's COVID, but no. There's a virus called sin. And Jesus Christ can redeem it. All you have to do is ask for forgiveness. He could forgive you. You have to come humbly at Him. We're not here like to scare you. We're not here to judge you or to condemn you. We're here to show you the love of Christ. But of course, if you act prideful towards us, then it's our job and duty to rebuke you. But we're not here to do that. We love you. We want you to have eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. Only He can set you free, my friends. And this is why in Hebrews 9:27 it says, for the appointment for a man wants to die, there is the judgment. Ya deja la sinvergüenzada, mi amigo. Ya deja la perversidad. Ya deja homosexual. Ya deja a tu novio, a tu novia, porque dice la palabra de Dios. Amas a tu padre, a tu madre, a tu esposo, a tu esposa, aleluya, a tu primo, a tu prima, etc. No eres digno, no es digno de mí, el que no quiera recoger tu cruz, no es digno de mí, dice el Señor Jesús, aleluya. Acts 3:19 says, repent ye and be converted, for your sins may be blotted out. For time of repentance has come to the presence of the Lord and to the glory of His power. I said it wrong in Spanish, but right now I'm preaching to you in English because there's a lot of Spanish and English speakers, hallelujah. Arrepiéntate, America. Arrepiéntate.
Ya no provoques la ira de
Dios. Ya no la provoques a Dios, porque Dios es un Dios de misericordia. Por eso no te ha tirado al infierno donde perteneces. I deserve hell. He deserves hell. All of us do. God gives us what we don't deserve, His grace and mercy. Because when you sin wrongfully, you're slapping God in the face, my friends. Sin is a disease. We don't want you to go to hell, my friends. So get off the broad path and get in the narrow path that leads to heaven. Get in the broad path, my friends. Get right with God before it's too late, my friends. Jesus Christ wants to give you eternal life. He's offering you eternal life through His Son, Jesus Christ. Please repent, my friends. I'm begging you to repent. Don't be afraid of this virus. Fear God. The Bible says in Matthew 10:28, do not fear those who could kill the body, but fear Him who could cast both body and soul to hell. Yes, I say to you, fear Him. Luke chapter 12, verse 5, Matthew 10:28. Says the same thing, to fear God. Ecclesiastes chapter 12, verse 13 to 14. He says, fear God and keep His commandments, for this is meant all. For God shall bring every secret thing into judgment, whether good or evil, whatever you're doing in the secret, God's going to expose you. Bless you, sir. Love you. Anyone who's passing by over here, Jesus is giving you the last request. You could tell us to shut up, but you will not tell this question to shut up on judgment. Everybody's going to want to hear about God and judgment. So cry out to Jesus, stop being a sinner, repent, ask Him for forgiveness. Stop being prideful, my friend. Jesus Christ came here to set you free. Jesus wants to set you free from whatever sin you do. He set me free from cursing. Like, I used to curse a lot, but not anymore. He set me free. I'm not a person. I'm not perfect. I'm not sure yet. But I'm here to show you the love of Christ because I care about you. I'm sorry. Me and this brother, we're sacrificing our time for you guys because we love you guys. We don't want you to perish in the lake of fire, but we want you to come to repentance. In Isaiah chapter
3. I think you have to be a little closer, bro, so it doesn't make that weird noise.
Oh. Isaías capítulo 1, verso número 15, dice: cuando extendáis vuestras manos, yo esconderé de vosotros mis ojos. Asimismo, cuando multipliques la oración, yo me oiré. Llenas están de sangre vuestras manos. Lavaos y limpiaos. Quitad la iniquidad de vuestras obras delante de mis ojos. Dejad de hacer lo malo. Verso 17. Aprended a hacer el bien y buscad el juicio. Restituyen al agraviado. Hacer justicia al huérfano. Emparad a la viuda. Venir luego, dice Jehová, les tomas en cuenta si vuestros pecados fueran como la grana, como la nieve serán enblanquecidos, si fueran rojos como el carmesí, vendrán a ser como blanca lana. Come now and let us visit to the accept the Lord. Though your sins may be as scarlet, they shall be as white as snow. Though they be red like crimson, they shall be as wool. So God is calling you to repentance in the Old Testament, both in Old and New Testament, my friends. Judgment is coming. God is a God of love, but He's also a God of righteousness. He's going to put your wrath on you if you don't repent. Reject the mark of the beast also. Because in Revelation 13, 16 to 18, it says that in the near future, you're not going to be able to buy yourself. The 7-year tribulation is the worst pandemic. You're going to suffer if you don't accept Jesus Christ. You must be right with Him, my friends. Thanking you for the blood of my heart, te pongo mi corazón. Te pido que te arrepientas, amigo, querido motorista, querido pasajero, querido amigo y amiga. Ven a los pies de Jesús. Cristo te ama, mi amigo, aleluya. Busca a Cristo antes de que sea demasiado tarde. So right now, I'm going to pass you guys to my friend over here. May God bless you guys and repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand.
So I just want many of you to know that you could still get saved, you could still be forgiven. We're living in a world that's falling into lawlessness. It's time to wake up. It's time to wake up, Los Angeles. It's time to wake up, all of California. You need to wake up because America's in big trouble. America needs to get right with God. Many of the schools are obviously taking out Bible teachings. The world has become so wicked. It's time to wake up, it's time to repent, it's time to get right with God. And Jesus Christ loves you all, for God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in Him should not perish, but have everlasting life. Yes, if you believe, you shall be saved. If you call on the name of the Lord, you shall be saved. Él te quiere salvar y Él te quiere mucho. Él no quiere que vayas al infierno porque no al cielo. Él hizo mucho por nosotros. He sacrificed so much for us. He did so much for us that He sacrificed for us. And yet, many people decide not to take it seriously. They take it as a joke. But you must repent. You won't be laughing when you stand before God. Neither will I. None of us. We'll all stand before God. To those people that believe that Jesus Christ is not coming back, I want you to know that you're wrong. You are big time wrong. And that Jesus Christ is coming back. He is coming back. The reason why you say that is because you don't know the Bible. You don't know God. You're unbelieving. You have unbelief. Why not change your unbelief to belief? Okay, maybe you had a tough time in your lifetime. You had a history in your lifetime where you were hurting.
No one cared about you. You were forced into religion. Well, I got news for you. Jesus Christ was near religious people. There are religious people that came against Jesus Christ. But Jesus Christ didn't fall for their tricks. He knew them. He knew everything about them. He knew them inside and out. He knew their minds. He knew they were trying to trick him. All those Pharisees and scribes. And you know what Jesus Christ said to them? Woe unto the Pharisees and scribes. Woe unto you. That's what he said. He hates work of iniquity. Jesus Christ hates the workers of iniquity. He hates work of iniquity. It's true that he loves us, but he hates it when we commit a sin. All the times we have failed him. I'm guilty of failing him so many times. I could have done better, but that just shows I'm not perfect. That shows I'm just like every one of you. I too have sinned. I too was pathetic. And Jesus Christ understands what I went through. He knows my heart. He knows the heart of all of you. You probably don't know my life. I probably don't know your life. But why not conversate or something? Maybe we could relate to something. Maybe we both have, maybe some of us had the same experience in our lifetime. Mistreated. Feeling like we were outcasts. But Jesus Christ loves us and he has a home for us in heaven. And Jesus Christ makes it clear in John chapter 14 that there are many, that he's going to prepare a place for us, a place where there'll be many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. And that's what Jesus Christ said, yes. And Jesus Christ is true. He is the way, the truth, and the life. No man comes to the Father but by me. And to all of you, I want to make it clear to most of you who say that we're shoving religion down a person's throat. I want you to know that you're wrong and that you don't know me. You don't know God. You say we're shoving religion down a person's throat. How can you know that if you don't know God? You don't know the relationship. You probably don't know the relationship we have with God that well. It's not about shoving the religion down a person's throat. It's basically telling you the truth, speaking to you, maybe witnessing to you, letting you know that you can be loved, letting you know the good news, letting you know about the gospel of Christ. There is a heaven and a hell. We have to tell you the good and bad news of what's made clear in the gospel. If we don't tell you the truth, how are you gonna take heed? How are you gonna listen? Well, I want to make it clear to you all that you need a Savior. You may reject it now, but when you stand before God, you won't be rejecting it. And don't go pointing fingers at me because it's not my fault. I told you, but you chose not to listen. You chose to be ignorant. And that's going to be your own fault. It's going to cost you for ignoring the truth, for ignoring something that I told you because I care for you. Many of you may rise up against us. In these last days, they're going to hate you for the faith. You know why they hate us? Because they hated Jesus Christ first. And that's a fact, and that's true. It's biblical. If you don't believe me, don't take my word for it. Read the Bible, because the Bible speaks the truth. You don't have to believe me. You may try to put words in my mouth. You could go ahead and do that. That's fine, because I still forgive you. If you want to put words in my mouth, I still forgive you. I'll keep telling you the truth, even if you don't like me for it. Even if it makes you hate me more and more. I'll keep telling you the truth because I care for you. It's time to believe. It's time to get right with God. I'm not telling you to get religious. I'm telling you to get serious with God. I'm telling you to get right with God, to have a relationship with God, to believe in the Lord God Almighty, the Lord Jesus Christ, who sits at the right hand of God. You probably don't understand it, but it says it somewhere in the Bible that Jesus Christ is standing at the right hand of God. Él está allá arriba. El Jesucristo, el Señor Jesucristo con el Padre. Y Él te quiere mucho, que te quiere salvar. Él te quiere salvar. Arrepiéntense ahora, porque mañana no es prometido. Tomorrow could be too late. It's time to repent and to get right with God. Time to wake up and wake up. The time to get right with God, to come to Christ, is now. If you don't know Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior, you could come here. We can answer your questions. If anybody needs prayer, we'll pray for you because we love you and we care for you. So if you need prayer, we'll pray for you. If you want to reject it, that's your loss, that's your problem.
But don't say it didn't warn you. Don't come crying to me when you stand before God on the day of judgment. You're going to wish you had listened when you had the chance.
And I'll keep going. I'll keep fighting the good fight. We must keep fighting the good fight of faith, those of us who are of Christ. Jesus Christ loves us and wants the best for us. He wants us to be saved. He wants us to have a personal relationship with Him. God loves everybody, yes. He loves the idolaters. He loves the adulterers. He loves the fornicators. He loves the haters. He loves the blasphemers. He loves everybody. Jesus Christ loves everyone. But don't take my word for it, like I said before or so. Read the Bible, because the Bible speaks truth. May God bless you guys that pass by. We're taking our time, we're sacrificing this time to let you know about the Lord Jesus Christ, who loves you. And He wants the best for you. He wants to save your soul from hell. If you don't believe me, please come to Christ today. I'm pleading with you guys to come to Christ. Si no lo conoces a él, ahora es el momento.
And I'm sorry if you don't like me so much, pero véname si me odias mucho y me quieres matar, if you want to kill me so much. I still love you guys. I don't care what any of you think of me. You may hate me. You may want me dead. But I still love you, no matter what, because I care for you. I'll keep telling you the truth until my time on this earth ends, until I die, until my time is up on this earth, until Jesus Christ comes to call me home, calls me home, until He calls me home, until the Lord Jesus Christ calls me home to the kingdom of heaven. Anyone else like the Lord Jesus Christ? He loves you all. He wants to have a personal relationship with you. Don't have to believe me, but He wants to save your soul. Come to Christ while there's still time. You never know what may happen tomorrow. And I'm not done yet, because I'm going to keep telling you the truth, the gospel of Jesus Christ, because I love you and I care about you so much. Be thankful I'm not like everybody else who doesn't care. Everybody else just has to be like, I don't care what's going to happen to this person. Be thankful that I care. Because I could have been the one to end up in hell if I died in my sin. The same could happen to any of you. If you don't know what I'm talking about, read the Bible. You don't want to read the Bible? That's your problem, okay? But I love you guys so much that I want you to know about the gospel of Jesus Christ. And by the way, Romans 6:23, for the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. Yes. Think about it. Okay, it's like you're paying your taxes, right? If you don't pay up your taxes, you're going to be charged more. Something similar can happen. Like if you die in your sins, you're going to have to pay those wages. You're going to have to pay extra taxes. Something like that. Jesus Christ wants to save you all. You don't have to believe me. You don't have to take my word for it. Time is running out. Time is short. You never know what may happen tomorrow. Okay? It's time to wake up. I don't want you guys to die in hell. I don't want you to end up there. You're probably going to be like, mind your own business. Why don't you care for yourself? No. I'm not going to care for myself. I'm going to care for all of you. Even if you don't like me, I'm supposed to love those who hate me. Love those who love me. I'm supposed to love as commanded by the Lord God Almighty. You don't have to believe me, because Jesus Christ knows I could be honest with Him. And Jesus Christ is truth. And you want to know, He said, what is truth? Pontius Pilate. He questioned Jesus being like, what is truth? It's so sad how he couldn't see it right in front of him. Right in front of him. Jesus Christ is the truth. It's sad how some people still can't see that right in front of their faces, in front of their eyes. They're still blind. They don't open their eyes to the truth. They don't want to come to Christ. They want to be stubborn, rebellious, and refuse Jesus Christ. If it weren't for Jesus Christ, we would all be in hell already, burning in hell. But be thankful that Jesus Christ came to save us, that we can be in heaven, that we can be forgiven of all our sins. If any of you know Jesus Christ, let me ask you something. Do you have a relationship with Him? Do you know God? Do you really take Jesus Christ seriously? Do you worship Him? Do you serve the Lord your God? Those are some questions I may ask you. If you say you know Jesus Christ, but your heart is far from Him,
If you say you know Jesus Christ, but your heart is far from Jesus Christ, you're a hypocrite, a Pharisee. I'm not trying to condemn anyone. I'm speaking the truth. Because many profess they know God, but those who profess they know God, but don't follow the ways of God, and their hearts are far from God, those are the hypocrites and Pharisees. Why else are they afraid? Why else do they follow the government and be like, okay, the government cares about us? No, many of you are deceived. You don't know the truth. You don't want to do your research. You just want to go along with whatever they're telling you. It's time to wake up, guys. You never know what may happen tomorrow. Get it together before it's too late. I would not want any of you to go to hell. I want many of you to go to heaven.
Amen.
Why reject the free gift of salvation? You could be saved by grace through faith. When it talks about we are saved by grace through faith, that is no excuse to continue in sin. Many people love to justify their sin. They love to use those verses to support their sin, to stand for their sin. But I got news for you guys. Your own sin will lead you to hell. Don't go to hell because of your sin. No sin on earth is worth going to hell for. It's time to wake up and get right with God. Turn away from all sins. Turn away from all iniquity and unrighteousness. If you die without Jesus Christ and you die in your sin, don't be surprised if the Lord Jesus Christ tells you, depart from me. I never knew you. Depart from me, you worker of iniquity. You that work iniquity. A worker of iniquity is someone that works wickedness. Or do you want the other option? If you die and you're in Christ, if you lived for Christ and you died for Christ, you'll be hearing, well done, my good and faithful servant. Isn't that what many of you want? The answer is no. You guys are probably ignorant. I probably have some ignorance too. I may not know everything. I probably get ignorant. I probably have gotten ignorant at times. Many of us have gotten ignorant. I don't think I'm the only one who's gotten ignorant. Many of us have. Many of us are ignorant because we lack knowledge. But if we lack knowledge, we can ask of God. Ask God for knowledge and He will give it to us. The Lord Jesus Christ will give us that knowledge. We must come to Christ and accept Him as our personal Lord and Savior. You never know what tomorrow may hold. Jesus Christ loves you all, and He's out to save your soul from the pits of hell. Jesus Christ wants to save your soul from hell. You never know what tomorrow may hold, because tomorrow could be too late. You may be making excuses, being like, oh, I'm going to get right with God later. No, it's going to be too late by then. Like, seriously, you may be staring. Do you have something to say? If you want to talk to me, come talk to me. We'll talk. I could get off the microphone if you want. If you want to talk to me, let's talk, okay? I'm concerned for you. If you don't know what I'm talking about, I care about you so much. I don't want you to die in hell. I want you to go to heaven. You may not care. You may not care what I say. That's fine, because what matters is what the Lord Jesus Christ, the Lord our God, says. What matters is what He says. If you have something to say, let's talk. Let's talk normally. Let's talk like civilized people. Okay, if you want to have a conversation, let's talk. I don't have to use the microphone if we talk. If you want to keep your distance from me and you want to use the microphone, okay, I get that. Okay, you're probably uncomfortable. Okay, I get it. All right. I probably get uncomfortable too with people. I get it. If I get too close to you, I understand. Okay, I'll give you a space. If you get too close to me, give me my space, okay? Is that fair? Do we come to an agreement? If so, then I do agree, okay? Let's give each other space then, okay? Well, if you're going to persecute me, I'll still forgive you whatever you do to me, okay? You may mock me, you may scoff me, you may start throwing stuff at me. I still forgive you at the end of the day because I love you. And as commanded by the Lord, well, as the Lord commands, we are commanded to forgive. Just as we forgive, our Father in heaven will forgive us. Forgiveness matters. We must forgive. It doesn't matter what wrong a person has done to you. We must forgive. We have no excuse. We must forgive. Because if we don't forgive, our Father in heaven will not forgive us of our sins. Time to wake up and come to the reality that you need Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior. That you need to be forgiven by the Lord Jesus Christ. You could be covered by the blood of Jesus Christ. He wants to wash away your sins with His precious blood. He wants to cleanse you. He wants to forgive you of all unrighteousness. He wants to forgive you of all rebelliousness and wickedness. He wants to make you new. If you come to Christ, you shall be a new creature.
All things will pass away, but all things will become new. Isn't that what you want? Do you want to be transformed by the Lord Jesus Christ? Do you want to be born again? To be born again is to have a transformed life in Jesus Christ our Lord. You must be born again. I believe this is spiritual speaking. This has to be spiritual speaking, not physically. You must be born again, a changed life. Start living a spiritual life according to the Lord Jesus Christ, if I make myself clear. But I love you guys so much, I want you to get saved. If you don't understand me, I'm sorry to hear that. If you wanted to talk to me, you could come out and talk to me. You could come up to me, all right? But just make sure you don't get close to me and just give me my space, all right? If you're going to want to talk to me, let's just keep it simple and civilized, okay? Let's just show some respect, okay? Because I care, okay? It's good to talk to people. We're supposed to socialize. We're supposed to talk to people. The best thing to do is talk to people about the Lord Jesus Christ. Witness to them. Let them know about the Lord Jesus Christ. Many people are annoyed by hearing the Lord Jesus Christ. Well, those people who are annoyed by the Lord Jesus Christ, they have problems, okay? Okay, I admit I have problems too. Don't get me wrong. I too have my problems. We all got problems. We all got things to deal with, okay? For instance, being the only born-again Christian in the household, I can understand that for those of us who are truly born-again, and some of us are the only true born-again Christians in the household. I get that. Persecution comes at you. They curse at you. They start hating on you. They go against you. Because they're probably like, why do you worship the Lord your God? Why do you worship the Lord your God? Well, because my God is real. My God is fair and righteous and loving. God bless you, sir. Amen.
God bless you.
This is our son of Israel. You know what I'm saying? The Quran was found way back in the biblical day in Egypt.
Jesus Christ loves you, sir.
Well, whatever that means, you know.
Prepare before it's too late.
By the way, y'all, I have to make it clear, we don't need extra books. We don't need the Quran.
Jesus.
We don't need the Book of Mormon. We need the Bible.
In the name of
we
Jesus.
Need a Bible.
You're not going to show the middle finger on
Judgment Day, sinner. B-L-E. Basic instructions before leaving Earth.
Perverso.
How else do you want me to explain it? Simple as that, right?
He's off his father.
Because it makes sense, right?
Look at what the sinner did to you, bro. He chose the middle finger.
You gotta follow the Lord Jesus Christ.
That's right, sinner. Repent.
And to those of you who wronged, I forgive you, okay? Next time, if there's ever time someone wants to use the microphone just to be dumb and just to curse,
you have no right.
You don't have my consent to use the microphone. All right? But if you're gonna talk to me in a respectful manner, then you have my consent to speak. To speak on the microphone, okay? But please, let's be respectful, okay? If you don't like it, just keep driving away, okay? But then again, I want you to hear the gospel. If you're being drawn close to the message, if you're being drawn close to the truth, there's a reason why. Maybe you're being convicted by God himself. Maybe Jesus Christ, the Lord our God, wants you to come to him, to surrender to him, to love him wholeheartedly. Surrender to the Lord your God. Jesus Christ loves you. It's time to wake up and realize you need him. Come on, guys, okay, we all got different lives, okay, we all live different lives, okay, probably some of us want nothing to do with each other, but that's no excuse. We're supposed to love one another, we need each other, we need to love one another, because you never know who's going to die, you never know where someone's going to go tomorrow or today. Come on now, get it together. It's time to realize that. If you still want to listen to the lies of this world, be my guest, but don't say I didn't want it because I did, okay? Don't go perishing. Don't go to hell in the lake of fire. Go to heaven instead. Repent and believe in the gospel of Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ is the Savior of the whole world, and Jesus Christ wants to save your souls. It's time to wake up. And by the way, one more verse, okay? 2 Peter chapter 3, verse 9. The Lord is not slack concerning his promise, but is long-suffering to usward, not willing that any should perish, but that all should come to repentance. You want to know what repentance means, to repent? It means to have a change of mind, to go from unbelief to belief.
Everything.
To have a change of way of living. To turn your way of living around. And to start living for the Lord your God. Start having that change of mind today. Come to repentance. Let Jesus Christ transform you into what he wants you to become. Jesus Christ wants you to be his child. Accept him today and you shall be a child of God. You will be welcomed into the kingdom of God. Wake up while there's still time, guys. God bless you guys, okay? Because Jesus Christ is coming soon and he wants to save your souls. So God bless you guys. Start believing in the Lord Jesus Christ. Repent and believe in the gospel of Jesus Christ. God bless you guys and take care. Bye-bye.
Bro, here, let me say something. Ooh, I'm on fire. So as we're saying, my friends, we're here because we care about you. Nosotros que queremos, mi amigo y amiga, si quieres oración, puedes pasar al frente de nosotros. Nosotros, no venimos a juzgar ni a criticarte. I don't know what you're going through. Mi tío murió hace 3 semanas. Yo no sé dónde está. Yo le he predicado pocas veces el evangelio. Pero mi tío, desgraciadamente, se ha distanciado de mi familia, aleluya. Yo no sé dónde está, yo por eso vengo aquí. Porque estamos en los tiempos finales, mi amigo. Dice la Biblia, buscar a Jehová mientras pueda ser hallado. Búscalo, amigo y amiga. Busca a Dios. Busca a Dios, aleluya. Dice Isaías 55, que buscar a Jehová. Tienes que buscar a Dios. Si tú te has descarriado, mi amigo, del evangelio, es hora que regreses a los pies de Jesús. Jesucristo quiere perdonar tus pecados. Nosotros podemos orar por ti, por cualquier petición que tengas, amigo y amiga. No sé si estás pasando por un divorcio, quizás tu mamá o tu papá no te quiere, quizás señora, señor, sus hijos son acreedores con usted, quizás usted perdió su trabajo, quizás está a punto de perder su casa por la renta. Pero déjame decirte, amigo y amiga, que el amor de Dios, nada ni nadie te va a desamparar, como dice Romanos capítulo 8 versos 35-39. Ven a Jesucristo, mi amigo, por favor, antes de que sea demasiado tarde. Quizás tú perdiste a tu mamá, a tu papá, a tu hijo, a tu hija, quizás alguien se murió, quizás tu esposo, tu esposa, tienes problemas en casa. Ven a los pies de Jesús. Estamos localizados en 631, aquí están los Boulevard, los Ángeles, California 90011, aquí está en la esquina de nuestra iglesia. Pero nuestra intención no es llenar nuestra iglesia, sino que tú seas salvo. Yo quiero tu alma, mi amigo. Yo quiero que tú tengas vida eterna y salvación. I want you to have salvation and eternal life, my friends. Maybe you're going through a divorce. Maybe your mom died. Maybe your dad died. Maybe your sister, your brother. Maybe you're going through a difficult time. But the Lord wants to bless you. The Lord wants to forgive you of your sins. No importa qué pecado hayas cometido. It doesn't matter what sin that you met. If you're a backslider, if you have departed from the faith, it's time to get back to Jesus Christ, my friend, my dear brother, my dear sister. Si tú eres cristiano, te invito a que prediques ese evangelio, este precioso evangelio que te puede salvar, amigo y amiga. Este evangelio te quiere dar vida, Jesucristo te quiere dar vida eterna. Él murió por ti, por mí. Nosotros no somos nada sin Dios. Necesitamos a Jesús, amigo y amiga. Nosotros queremos que tú seas salvo. We want you to obtain salvation. Si tienes un dolor, if you have pain, si te duele la cabeza, o tienes artritis, cáncer, coronavirus, lo que sea, ven para acá y nosotros pues podemos orar por ti. Podemos orar por ti con tu permiso. Si quieres platicar con nosotros, puedes platicar. Nosotros te queremos mucho, amigo. We love you so much, my friend. We're here because maybe one person needs to hear it. I don't know who I'm talking to. Yo no sé a quién estoy hablando en esta tarde. Pero sé que alguien acá, hay personas con muchos problemas. Pero déjame decirte que Jesucristo te ama. Aunque tú nos insultes, aunque tú nos ofendas, no te lo estás ofendiendo a nosotros, amigos. Estás ofendiendo a Dios, aleluya. No es fácil la vida, pero tienes que seguir. If you're going through a breakup, si tu novio o tu novia te dejó, your boyfriend, your girlfriend dumped you, it's okay. God has someone for you. God will never leave you nor forsake you. Dios nunca te va a abandonar ni te dejará. Él no cambia, es el mismo, hoy, mañana y siempre. Él te quiere salvar, Él te quiere sanar tus heridas. Clámale a Dios, pídele perdón a Dios de tus pecados. Él te quiere perdonar. God wants to forgive you, my friends. He could help you. Just surrender all to Him. Dale tu ser a Jesús, amigo y amiga. Reconcíliate con Dios. Si tú te saliste del Evangelio, es hora que vuelvas a casa. Porque el tiempo se agota. Time is running out. Jesucristo ya está a punto de venir a recoger a su iglesia. Y si tú no estás preparado, no vas a lamentar, amigo y amiga. Vas a sufrir la gran tribulación. Y si mueres esta noche sin Jesús, vas a ir a un lugar de condenación llamado infierno, donde el gusano no muere, ni el fuego nunca se apaga. The worm doesn't die, the fire never crushes in hell. According to Isaiah chapter 66, verse 24, and Mark 9, 43 to 48, the worm doesn't die, and the fire never crushes, my friends. It's time for you to get ready with the King of Kings and Lord of Lords. Jesus wants to forgive you for your sins, my friends. Él quiere perdonar tus pecados. Nomás ven a Él. Ven a Él. Él es tu descanso. No queremos que sufras la ira de Dios. Huye la ira de Dios. Plead the wrath of God. Because God is true. He's a God of love. But He's also a God of wrath. He's going to pour His wrath upon you. He's going to take revenge on you. According to Jude 14:15 says that He's going to come with thousands of His saints to execute His judgments for those who don't know Him. Jesús va a venir pronto, va a tomar venganza con millones y millones de sus millares, como dice Judas 14:15, y se vengará de todos los pecadores que no se arrepintieron de corazón. Si tú estás en pecado, amigo, es hora que busques a Dios, porque no sabes cuándo vendrá tu hora. Tú te puedes morir en cualquier momento. Quizás usted dirá, no, hermano, yo como bien, soy saludable, soy aquí, soy allá. Pero tú nunca sabes, amigo y amiga, hasta la gente que se cuida bien. Como te decía antes, no tomes la marca de la bestia. The mark of the beast is coming. No vas a poder ni comprar ni vender. Dice Apocalipsis capítulo 14.
It's 13, right? Because they say...
Déjame ir a Apocalipsis. Okay. Rechaza la marca de la bestia, porque si tú aceptas la marca de la bestia, irás al infierno, amigo y amiga. Te lo voy a leer en inglés y en español. Yo te voy a... Si el aguado de tu pastor no te quiere predicar, yo sí te voy a predicar. Yo sí te voy a dar. I'll preach to you. Even if your sissy pastor doesn't want to preach to you, I'll preach to you. I'll preach to you hell and fire. But I'm not trying to scare you. I want you to get right with God.
Preach.
Revelation chapter 13. The great revelation is coming. It's coming real soon. It says, and... He calls them all, both small and great, rich and poor, free and bond, to receive a mark in the right hand and the forehead, that no man should buy by yourself, save he that had the mark, or the name of the beast, or the number of his name. He was supposed to let him that have understanding count the number of his name, for this number is 666. Y hacía que todos, pequeños y grandes, ricos y pobres, libres y esclavos, se les pusiese una marca en la mano derecha o en la frente, y que ninguno pudiese vender ni comprar, sino que tuviese la marca en la bestia, en la frente o en la mano. Aquí es el que tiene entendimiento. El número de la bestia, pues es por supuesto el hombre, es el 666. Apocalipsis 14 dice, verso número 9 dice de esta manera, y el tercer ángel lo siguió diciendo a una gran voz, si alguno adora a la bestia y es su imagen, recibe la marca en su frente o en su mano, él también beberá el vino de la ira de Dios, que ha sido vaciado, puro, en cáliz de su ira, y será atormentado en fuego y azufre, delante de los santos ángeles y el cordero, y el humo de su tormento, dice aleluya, sube por los siglos de los siglos, y no tienen reposo ni día ni de noche, los que adoran a la bestia, ni a su imagen, ni que recibe el nombre de la bestia. And the smoke of the torment ascended up forever and ever. And they have no rest day nor night. Who worship the beast of his image, and whosoever receives his mark on his right hand or his forehead. Te van a crecer unas úlceras tan grandotas, amigos, si te pones la marca. Dice Apocalipsis 16:1-2. Oí una gran voz que decía, desde el templo, los siete ángeles, id y derramad sobre la tierra las siete copas de la ira de Dios. Fue el primero y derramó su copa sobre la tierra. Y vino más una úlcera maligna y pestilente,
sobre los hombres que tenían una marca y la bestia que adoraban a su imagen. And I heard a great voice out of the temple say to the seven angels, go your way and pour out the vials of the wrath of God upon the earth. And the first went and poured out his vial on the earth and poured a great noisome of grievous upon man, which had the mark of the beast and upon him which is worship his image. If you put the mark of the beast, my friends, you're going to get in trouble with God. There's no forgiveness for you. Rejected at all costs. It doesn't matter where it is, rejected. Because the Bible said, if you desire to save your life, you'll lose it. But whosoever loses his life for my sake and for the gospel shall save it. You could gain the whole world all you want, my friends, but it's not going to profit you nothing. Unfortunately, this mission ain't for everybody. So it's up to you if you want to accept it or receive it. You know, you could flip that as all you want. You could show us the middle finger. And you know, if you want to talk, you know, we could talk, my friends. We're here because we love you. We care about you. Because the Bible said that if any person is not found written in the book of life, shall be cast in the lake of fire. So let me read Revelation chapter 21, verses. Apocalipsis 21, no, verso 7 dice, el que vendiere heredará todas las cosas, yo seré su Dios, y él será mi hijo. Pero los cobardes, incrédulos, abominables homicidas, fornicarios y hechiceros, los idólatras, y todos los filtrosos tendrán su parte en el lago que arde con fuego y azufre, es la muerte segunda. But the fearful, but he that overcometh shall inherit all things, and I will be his God, and he shall be my son. But the fearful, the unbelieving, the abominable, murderers, whoremongers, torturers, idolaters, and all liars shall have a part in the lake which burneth with fire and brimstone, which is the second death. There's two books, my friends. Are you in the book of life or are you in the book of second death? The Bible says, choose today who you will serve. Escoger a quien vas a servir. Dice la palabra de Dios en Josué 24:15. Escoger a quien vas a servir, amigo y amiga. Mateo 7:13. Aleluya. Eso se está poniendo bueno. Gloria a Dios. Alabado sea el Cordero. Entra por la puerta estrecha, porque ancha es la puerta y espacioso es el camino que lleva a la perdición. Y muchos son los que entran por ella, porque estrecha es la puerta y angosto es el camino que lleva a la vida, y pocos son los que la hallan. Enter ye by the straight gate, for broad is the way that leadeth to destruction, and many shall be thereat. Because straight is the gate, and narrow is the way which leadeth unto life, a few will find it. So in other words, many are going to go to hell, a few are going to go to heaven. Are you one of the many or are you one of the few? ¿Eres de los pocos o eres de los muchos? La Biblia te enseña, amigo y amiga, que en el infierno hay mucha gente. La mascarilla no te va a salvar de la ira de Dios, ni la vacunita. Nada de eso te va a salvar. Solo la sangre de Cristo, aleluya, es la que te puede salvar, amigo y amiga. Reconcíliate con Jesús antes de que...